As an IVF expert, I am always looking for methods to improve the chances for pregnancy for my patients. For many years, I have recommended using the medication metformin for women with PCOS or insulin resistance in order to increase the chance for ovulation. Some doctors have recommended using metformin to improve IVF success. Does it work? Let's find out. Metformin is a medication used commonly by fertility specialists. Metformin works by reducing the body's resistance to insulin. Insulin resistance is the reason that some women, such as women with PCOS or obesity, don't ovulate. Reducing insulin resistance with metformin will result in some women being able to ovulate and become pregnant without the use of fertility medications. You can learn more about that here. IVF does not rely on ovulation. Although fertility medications are used, the eggs are removed from the ovary before ovulation. So why would metformin help? Really, I think that it's unclear why it would. Some doctors have pointed to the fact that some hormones, such as testosterone, are lowered and that this might help. One small study suggested that maybe the embryo quality was better. Really though, there is no solid scientific reasoning why metformin would improve IVF. There are many small studies on this topic. Some have found a benefit to the use of metformin and some have not. If you are a subscriber to Infertility TV, and you should be a subscriber to Infertility TV, you know that when this happens, the best thing to do is to combine all of the data from the smaller studies and analyze it together as one bigger study. The larger number of study subjects helps us to form more definite conclusions. This is known as a meta-analysis. In 2014, a meta-analysis combined the data from 9 studies involving a total of 816 women with PCOS. About half of the women received metformin, and the other half either took no medication or used a placebo or fake medication. This analysis found that the live birth rate was the same in PCOS patients whether they took metformin or not. A few months ago, this meta-analysis was updated. There were now 13 studies involving over 1,100 women. In this analysis, they also found no increase in the live birth rate. With the added numbers, they were also able to break down the IVF cycles into different medication protocols and look at the miscarriage rate. Bottom line is that there was no benefit to metformin. Last year, a different group of researchers also did their own meta-analysis, but they also failed to show any improvement in the chance for a live birth. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this. Using metformin does not appear to increase the success rate for women with PCOS who are doing IVF. I do want to point out one thing, however. Using fertility medications for IVF can sometimes result in a complication called ovarian hyperstimulation syndrome, or OHSS. Women with PCOS tend to be very sensitive to fertility medications and therefore have a higher risk for developing OHSS. Although metformin did not result in more babies being delivered, all 3 meta-analyses found that the risk of OHSS in PCOS patients was lower in those who took metformin compared to those who did not take it. In fact, there were less than half as many cases of OHSS in women who took metformin. On the other hand, metformin can cause women to have gastrointestinal side effects. So if your doctor thinks your risk for OHSS is low, there is probably no reason to take metformin. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.